Hello and welcome to the Getting Started with SOTI MobiControl series. My name is Richard, one of the senior principal instructors here at SOTI, and I'm joined by David, who is also a senior principal instructor.
In the previous videos, we've seen how lockdown and authentication profiles can be configured, and now it's time to start considering applications. This episode is going to cover how to use packages to provision company apps.
You'll see how to apply a package and even modify lockdown settings to reflect changes live on the device.
All right, so let's begin by describing what are packages. Now, packages are the equivalent of a big compressed file that's going to include three types of things. Number one is applications, which, you know, is what we're going to be demonstrating today. You can also add files, and Richard, you can also add scripts to them.
And when it comes to the scripts, the reason why these are included is because there are some company applications and files that need actions to occur either pre-installation or after an installation. So let's say, for example, install an application that requires other processes to be closed down to make sure that it installs successfully.
Now, we can even use one of these scripts to notify the user that, for example, an application was successfully installed. So how can we create a package?
Well, there's actually a few different ways. There's a dedicated area in SOTI MobiControl called Packages and a feature called Package Studio where you can add all the applications, the files, and the scripts that you require, bundle them together as a package.
And we can use that from within the MobiControl console in a specific version, or we can use the legacy Package Studio, which is something that continues to work even today. This is going to create a PCG file that can simply be uploaded into SOTI MobiControl after the fact.
For now, we'll focus on the web console-based Package Studio.
In order to make sure that you can take advantage of this, please make sure that you are on SOTI MobiControl 2024 or higher, as this integration was added in this version.
And David, once the packages are created, how do we go about deploying them? How do we get them onto the device so they can be used?
So Richard, in the previous section, I noticed how you and Anton were creating profiles and there was a third tab at the top that said packages. And that's where the packages that we are creating are going to be uploaded and they will be used to deploy the available information contained in these packages to these devices, and you can even version control the applications that you're sending them.
Okay, so let's get started. We'll go to our hamburger menu, we'll go to packages, and in here we can see all the packages that have been previously created. And as we said, we're using the inbuilt, the web console-based Package Studio, so we can click the option of add package. We've got an option for import, but in our case, we'll be clicking create. We can see that our platforms for packages include Android, Windows, and Linux. In our example, we'll be focused on Android as we've been going throughout this series. And the first thing I'll need to add is a package name. And I'm gonna make sure that this name is very, very clear. So I'm gonna click add package, I'm gonna click create, and in our focus for this series, we're focused on Android devices.
All right, so before we go through this process, Rich, what should you have prepared in order to get us started? What should you have ready? And what would be your recommendations from that perspective?
Okay, so essentially we need the applications, the files, and the scripts designed and ready to go. So I'll give this a quick name and a description. And please note that we have a very specific name for the package, which includes the version number of the package. Now, this should correlate to the version number that's been provided by the developer, and also the version number that you can see later down on this screen as well.
Now, this is going to be extremely important because as you create several different packages, you're probably going to be looking for the correct one that you want to correlate to the profiles that you want to send to devices. So it's just going to keep things more organized.
Another important step is making sure we specify the operating system version, particularly for company applications that have been developed specific to that organization. The developer may have given advice that this will apply to particular operating system versions. So we'll specify the range here. So once we've got this set, we'll then go to files and click the plus button. So we have a choice of adding a file, a folder, or an APK. So the first thing I'm going to choose is an APK. And in our example, we're going to click browse and we will upload SOTI Surf.
For those that are new to SOTI Surf, this is our very own enterprise-grade browser that allows your users to navigate your intranet in a secure manner, but also allows you to customize your browser experience and make sure that your users are focused on what they need to get done.
And of course, the same process of this uploading can apply to any other company APK as well. And we have further options, such as making sure that a user cannot uninstall this application. I'll repeat the process, but now I will choose a file. So let's say we also are looking to provision a configuration file for a specific company process to device. It's just the case of clicking Browse, Upload, and then specifying where that file is going to live on the device. And the third step leads us onto scripts. And as you know, David, you mentioned a few examples of previously, here we have our pre-install, our post-install, or pre-uninstall or post-uninstall scripts that can be applied. And in our case, we'll just add a script that's post-uninstall to advise the user that SOTI Surf has been successfully installed.
And if you were to choose, you could actually have one that is going to happen before the installation to let someone know something's going to happen on your device and a new application is coming.
So I think we've got everything that we need added. I'm going to hit save. And then next we have the option of publishing. Okay. Our package, our combination of applications and files and folders and scripts, what we need has now been published. But how do we send that to the devices again?
All right, so once again, to remind everybody, packages do not go on their own. They have to be added into a profile.
Okay, we'll head to profiles. We'll click Add Profile to create a new profile. We'll focus on Android. And once again, we will add a very, very clear name to our profile. And David, notice the profile name that I'm using matches the package name that we saw in our previous steps.
And that is going to be very important, Richard, because as you create more and more configurations and profiles in your environment, this is going to help you troubleshoot, know what exact profiles are going to be sending what to which devices, and also if you need to update the application, it's going to make it very easy to know where to go in order to make this happen.
And as you mentioned, we had configurations, which we looked at in a previous video, but there we have a tab called packages. So it's the case of clicking here, clicking the plus button, and there we have it. Our package is listed there, ready for us to provision to the device. There was a quick aside, you might see on the top right-hand side, there's a plus button here as well. So if there is a single application that you're looking to provision to the device, you've actually got a bit of a shortcut that you can upload this here directly, and it will add it as a package as well.
Now, after this is done, you will then be assigning this profile to one of your existing groups, or if you want to use the filter, you can filter specific devices in order to make sure that only devices that need this package get it.
Let's head back to our device now we've assigned this. Let's click on the configurations tab for our device, and we can see that our package is successfully installed. So David, our application and our scripts and all the other associated things are on the device. One final question. Let's say that we want to modify the lockdown that we've referred to in a previous video to reference the SOTI Surf browser.
All right, well, there's two ways to do it. Now you can go back to the configurations section where you will find the profiles area and find the profile that you need to modify in order to make the changes to the lockdown menu. But I will offer an easier way, which is in the group where this device lives, right-click on it, then click on Policies and Profiles. And once you do that, there is a tab called Profiles and Policies, and you will see all of the profiles that are targeting this group. There is a link for each of them. You click on it, and voila, it actually opens the specific profile, so you're ready to modify it.
So now it's a case of editing that. I'll go back into configurations, I'll go into lockdown, and I'll add a new home screen item. We know that the application is on the device because we've already got our package on the device, but I'll specify the identifier, the package name, and I'll give it a name of SOTI Surf. And that's a case of just reassigning that lockdown profile and having a quick look at the device.
With your internal apps deployed through packages, you've just added another layer of control to your device fleet. Keep watching this space, there's more to come.
Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest updates.